I'm just fronting it. I'll take it.
I meant to understand what he's saying. Just to get my head round, you've got to come foam in. Is it like a white foam?
Yeah.
And what are you going to front it with when it's all in
stonework?
With what sort of stonework? Stonework, right?
Yes.
Because normally you might have got the stonework, but then use one of these long arms and put cement down the back.
You would if you could.
If you get it there. Would you say, a lot of people escape up here, that was possibly thought of a cheap option?
Yeah, it wasn't a cheap option, it was the only option we thought would work really. I mean the rock armour option was over £500,000. And as I say, it didn't seem to meet the request. So we weren't trying to do it cheaply. Where it went wrong was, I keep saying, and I'm repeating this now, was the wall had been repaired in the past elsewhere. The grouting had been done to stabilise parts of the wall, and parts of the wall had been repaired. And this was 2 years of wall repair. But it wasn't done over the spare minimum we can. I think if I'd seen the pictures of 2004 and 2007, and seen the extent of the damage around the corner, I think you might have said, well, hang on a minute, it's more than just filling this hole. But the work went ahead, but it wasn't done on that basis. It was a genuine attempt to fix it.
Anybody else got any more questions?
I'm sorry, I know you've spoken so much before, I'm still not clear. Bringing material in is a problem. There is an overhang which is a risk to life. Why? What is stopping the overhang becoming the material we need? What prevents the overhang becoming the material we can't transport in? I think Chris touched on it, but I didn't hear a response to it.
I think there was some considerable calls by some structural experts and on the actual manufacturer. So what this mode has actually got the potential to do is to act as a structural stabiliser. So it actually forms an actual seal with the actual rock it's actually supporting. And this has been done globally, and it was seen as the best solution. If you're just actually putting, say, sandstone from the island itself, you're never ever going to get anything that's really, really tightly packed. That possibly is an option, but in terms of the actual force, then it's not going to take as much as this potential stone could do. The actual wall in front of it is 2 meters thick, so you've got your sandstone facing bricks. Then you've actually got other layers of block behind that, and then you've actually got structural support there as well. So that's the thing behind it.
And in terms of the overhang, you're right. You could leave it to come down itself. You could bring it down. The way you would normally bring it down is you bring in a large track machine like that they used in demolition, so with a very long arm, to keep it away from the cliff and bring it down piece by piece. Or the only other suggestion has been that you would use some small explosive devices on top of the cliff and you bring that piece down that way. The only thing with that is that there's no way back after that, because you're going to really struggle then if you decide subsequently to rebuild the wall. A ton of stuff on the beach, you had it would work. Stuff would go on the beach, some of it would wash into the cave, you might even cover the opening completely. The beach would reprofile itself around that. So it would work. It's just again the feasibility of getting the equipment you need. But it needs the discussion first, because like everything in life, I think there are going to be various views on this. And some people have surprised me and said, yeah, actually just bring it down. And I thought they would be the very opposite. And then people I thought would say, don't do that, to survive in the way. So the debate needs to be had. It remains an option, not the easiest of options. It would also need a lot of discussion, wouldn't it? We've been on there, things have gone badly wrong once. You would need some kind of consensus before you decide what to do next, really.
Yeah, I agree, it's not a temporary solution that's ideal, but rock armour was a feasible option that we looked at. Some of the overhang takes some of the weight out, and some of the rock acts as a temporary block until we can get to a point where we know exactly in that marine environment. And the third bit is about to break away because there's a fissure. I understand it's a bigger project, but just as a temporary solution, removing the risk of death and showing up at the bottom, that's what would happen naturally.
It is, yes. And it was the overhang, it was the reason the fire service declined to put the fire out, they just wanted to burn out. They were not prepared to put people underneath that over. Because they could have taken some equipment over there, and they could have attempted to put the fire out. But it was the old man that said that should be in outside.
If this incident hadn't happened, we wouldn't have this report in front of us tonight. We wouldn't be sitting here discussing the way forward. So my recommendation three included a couple of busy projects, including the list of properties on the island, including vacant properties to bring them back into use. Why is that forming part of the recommendation? If it hadn't happened, where would that recommendation have gone?
Well, it would, Chair, being brutally honest here, I put that in because I didn't want it to be lost. I think some of you know that I'm not enjoying the best of health at the minute, and I just didn't want that to be lost because it seemed to me that the opportunity should be taken to have a record there somewhere where members approved the idea that officers should do a capital B. As I said before, they're three striking properties, they've had a lot of time to them, they don't currently have a purpose, and they're at a point where we don't invest in them, they're listed, we want to keep them, they're part of the history. The investment in 5 years' time or 10 years' time would be pro rata much more than they need now. So you can blame me for that one. I put it in as a marker just in case I wasn't around and was there listed with the other things. But it can stay and I'll come out. And
happy to leave, but I just want to know why it wasn't.
Speaking to more councillors about the
I also picked up from the French group that it's a debate they wanted to have, and for whatever reason, the council officers, they didn't feel it would be particularly receptive. But it is a debate that needs to be had. They're three properties. They'll never be normal houses because they don't have any main supplies, but they are capable of being lived in. And for example, the Bird group on the island have already said to me that they made approaches previously, which they felt hadn't been taken up. And I said to them, well, we'll look at it again. Like any property, if we can get it into a decent state and then somebody takes it on and somebody uses it, it's better than standing empty.
Okay, on those,